This is West Grand Boulevard in the city of Detroit, Michigan, at the corner of Hanover Street, where Eddie Kendricks lived just a few doors up the street. January 8, 1964, just 6 weeks after President Kennedy was assassinated and 4 weeks before the Beatles landed, he was joined in his kitchen by David Ruffin, Paul Williams, Otis Williams, and Melvin Franklin. They were there to rehearse a song because that night they had a recording session at the Motown Studios. Bobby Rogers and Smokey Robinson had written a song for them called The Way You Do the Things You Do. It was to be the song that would clear their path through rock and roll history and pave their road to stardom. I'm gonna take that same walk they took, these long four blocks, up to the Motown Studios. And I'm now here at Hitsville, USA on West Grand. I'm gonna meet some friends here, not the Temptations, but some very special ladies. And I want you to meet them too. Ladies, I just walked four blocks from Hanover.
Why didn't you just hitchhike?
Because he's a stubborn kind of fella.
These ladies are my pride and joy. Those three songs that we just named were the first time we ever heard their voices back in 1962. Here at Hitsville, USA, they backed up Marvin Gaye on those three songs. And then at the end of 1962, in November, they were given their first hit, Come and Get These Memories, where Martha and the Vandellas, Rosie and Annette, gained worldwide fame.
I thought of what I wanted to do was to be an airline stewardess.
Let's take a step back into Vandellas history. Will you go with me?
Sure. All right.
Okay, ladies, let's go.
Basically, when I was going here, I wasn't at Hitsville at the time.
Okay.
We were still the Delphi's. It was myself, a girl named Gloria Jean Williams, or Johnson, a girl named Trudy, Beatrice, and Annette. We would get together and rehearse. I would go down to the Brewster Projects where Mr. Larkins had the groups together, and we would rehearse down at the Brewster Projects. The Delphi's did perform in this building. We did a couple, one show one time for my class in this building. While we were Delphi's, we lost two of our girls. Kind of ended up with it being just myself, Annette, and Gloria Jean. So Gloria Jean knew Martha. And so Gloria invited Martha into our group as the Delphi. That's when Martha started to working at Motown, Vicki Stevenson. And she invited us down to do some background work. And Gloria was also still with the group. So we went to Motown to do background work. That's when Barry decided that he was going to record the group, Come Get These Memories. But that was without Gloria. But our first recording was I'll Have to Let Him Go. Before that, we did a recording at Motown called You'll Never Cherish a Love So True, and Gloria Jean led that. We also recorded with J.J. Barnes. We did a tune called, we backed him up on a tune called Won't You Let Me Know. We in turn recorded a tune called I'll Let You Know, which Gloria led, and Martha was in the background. So then I say, now I'll go back to Motown. So around about the 60, 61, that's when I graduated. That's when we began to spend more time at Motown, and we actually, Barry wanted to record the group, and he called and said, have you got a name yet? We said, no. And there was myself, Annette, Martha, and Gloria. So he just said, well, you're going to be called the Vandellas.
In Detroit, I know for sure. I'm Baptist, and all Baptist black children had to attend church, of course, on Sundays, and they also had to be in something. They had to do something in church. They had to be an usher. They had to be in a choir. They had to do something. So I chose to be in the choir. I used to sing around the house with the mop handle and the broom handle, and I wanted to be a nurse or a social worker. I ended up as a Delphi first and then a Vandella, yes.
So tell us how that happened.
Well, once I got to high school, I had a friend that I went to high school with. Her name was Beatrice, And she had heard about an audition that was going on downtown at the Y. And she wanted to attend this. She was actually a singer. She had a very nice, soft, sweet, kind of pillow talk voice. And she wanted to attend the audition. The audition was for a girls group. The gentleman, Edward Larkins, had a guys group, and he wanted to form a female group. So she asked me to ride downtown with her, and I did.
What do you mean ride downtown? Your mother take you or took the bus?
No, we took the bus everywhere we went, or either we walked. I walked up here every day for quite a few years, and it's quite a few blocks from where I used to live.
It was a pretty long distance from where you lived.
Oh, yeah, a good 12, 13, 15 blocks.
But rather than walk to the audition, you took a bus with Beatrice?
Yes, because the audition was downtown.
Okay. Did Beatrice get the job?
She did. She did get picked. But so did I. I went to ride downtown on the bus with her. We were 14 years old. Okay, I think she might be a year older than me. But I simply went to go downtown with her, you know. So, no, I did not go with the intentions of becoming a singer. There was a lot of ladies in there, a lot of young women who were auditioning. And he was bamming out notes on the piano, you know. And they had chairs all around. And he auditioned all these ladies. And then he turned and he looked at me and he said, "Hey, you, come here. Come sing this note." And he was bamming out something. And I was like, "Who, me? I didn't come to audition. I came with her." You know, he said, "Oh, come on, sing this note." You know, and I'm like, So he said, "Oh, come on. So I went up and I was standing there next to the piano. And he bammed out a little note with his finger, you know. And he said, "Give me an ah." So I went, "Ah." So then he hit another one. He said, "Well, sing that one." And I went, "Ah," you know. So we did that a few times. And he said, "Okay, go sit down." And I was like, "Whew, wow." You know.
I can go home now.
Yeah. It's like, I didn't want to do that, you know. So after he got through auditioning all the ladies, after a while, he said, "Okay, I got my group." So I'm like, "Okay, now we can get ready to go home, me and my girlfriend, you know." So he said, You, and you. And I was like, "No, not me. I can't do that. I didn't come here for this. I came with her. She wants to sing. I don't want to sing." He said, "Oh, it'll be good for you. So that was the beginning. That was the first time I met Rosalind.
Tell me, after 50 years, what does it mean to each of you to be a Vandellan?
Well, for me, it's been quite an honor. Or I should say it is quite an honor, because when it all started, I never thought in terms of even becoming a singer, less more what they consider a star. But I mean, well known by everybody. People stop us on the street and they just go, "You're somebody, you sing with somebody, I know you do," you know. But it's just a nice feeling. It's a nice feeling to be a part of history, to be in the history books, that even the young people know about it.
Well, I kind of feel the same way, but it's just something that I love to do, and whenever I'm on stage, I get very excited. I think I'm more active on stage than I am through my whole life. Once I step on stage, I'm a different person. It's just thrill, and I'm still excited. Every time I go on stage, I get excited.
So after 50 years, for you, Rosie, that excitement is still there.
It's still there, yeah.
I have a feeling, until the last time you perform, that excitement, that thrill, is always going to be there.
I hope so.
Let me tell you, for me, when I see you ladies perform, it takes me back. I'm 15 years old when I hear you sing, because all of your music has been with me through so many stages of life. You know, emotions don't age. Our bodies age. Look in the mirror and I say, "Oh my God, where did the hair, where did the 50 years go?" But my emotions are still the same, and you still get those same feelings when you hear all that great music. So I love it, and I'm looking forward to the next time that I get to see you ladies perform. So we're going to keep in touch.
Yes.
Okay?
Oh, sure.
We're never going to get out of touch.
Right. No. Right.
And when you are going to be performing the next time, make sure that you send me an email.
We will.
No matter where it is,
sure will.
I'm going to be there.
We will. We'll let you know.
Okay?
Yes.
Okay, ladies. see you again real soon.
Thank you. Okay. It's been a pleasure. Oh.